There are major differences in cancer incidence, survival and mortality between countries and within countries between individuals and groups belonging to different social strata. These differences, they reflect, they are not random, they do not occur at random, but they reflect the unequal distribution of risk factors and then in the unequal access to the healthcare system. So men and women with low social status and vulnerable groups, including ethnic groups or indigenous population, they are exposed to a wider range of risk factors. They usually get diagnosed with advanced disease and they are less likely to receive effective treatments compared to their fellow citizens. Therefore, they have a higher incidence of certain types of cancers, in particularly infection-related and smoking-related cancers. And they have lower survival and higher mortality for the vast majority of cancer compared to their fellow citizens.
This volume is based on the work of 70 international experts coming from different fields, and it gathers information and the most up-to-date evidence on social inequalities in cancer. It gives evidence in every continent and focuses on vulnerable groups. It also underlies important mechanisms and contextual factors underlying those social inequalities, such as policies, laws, national economy, and health system and technological advances. Finally, it lists research priorities and gives real-world evidence on how to tackle social inequalities in cancer.
Social inequalities in cancer have been observed for since long time. In the past decades, there have been a major progress in understanding the causes of cancer, in major progress in early detection and diagnosis and treatment of cancer. However, social inequalities in cancer continue to persist, although changed in the nature and transformed. These inequalities are follow a social gradient, therefore they affect everyone, but they hit particularly hard on the most disadvantaged population. On the global level, at the global scale, although incidence rates are higher in high-income countries, low and middle-income countries are suffer disproportionately more from mortality compared to high-income countries. And this fact is quite important because the future burden of cancer are going to impact relatively, they're going to have a relatively higher impact on less affluent countries.
Social inequalities in cancer can be eliminated or reduced. Effective public health policies that can reduce social inequalities in cancer include vaccination and screening programs, tobacco control, legislation, and also the use of low-cost medical devices, particularly in low-income settings. It is also important for the research agenda to include three priorities. The first one is to generate and monitor social inequalities in cancer and cancer risk factors. The second is to focus on the research on prevention. Prevention has the highest potential for reducing inequalities in all settings, and it is dramatically underfunded. And finally, it is important that every intervention programs and cancer control programs are designed to reduce and not to exacerbate social inequalities in cancer. Mm-hmm.